In this video, I want to talk about DeFi Empire Games, which is going to be launching very soon. Right now, there will be a pre-sale tomorrow for those on the whitelist. Then 24 hours after that will be the public pre-sale for people that want to get in. But there is a limited amount of tokens. Therefore, I need to get this video to you as soon as possible. Before I get started, this is not financial advice. Do your own research. This is for entertainment and educational purposes only. Now, I'm sharing this because I think that this project definitely has potential, right? So let's look at what it is. DeFi Empire will start by building and improving upon already existing forks that have been proven to be popular. Then we gradually grow into a much wider ecosystem on the Binance Smart Chain, where you can find all your favorite DeFi games projects. So first and foremost, they're modeling success by creating forks that have already been successful, right? Second of all, they're creating an ecosystem, right, which gives the token utility. And third of all, they're on the Binance Smart Chain, right? And fourth of all, they're in DeFi gaming and projects. So let's look now here. If we go to the website, we'll go to read the white paper first, right? Well, I have it right here. So read the white paper and we will see. DeFi Empire, the official DeFi Empire white paper. DeFi Empire is an ecosystem on the Binance Smart Chain where everyone can enjoy the most popular and profitable DeFi project games, all in one secure and trustworthy environment with transparent rug-free contracts. We will be gradually evolving the ecosystem, right? Releasing at least one new feature per 2 months, developing decentralized applications where users can invest. Governance token. The governance token of our ecosystem will be DeFi Empire Gold, DEG, and its utility will increase with each new project we release, starting with Jace, the Aspiring Adventurer. So the utility of their native token, DEG, will increase with each game they come out with. The first game will be Jace, the Aspiring Adventurer, right? Which is where you can invest and earn a percentage on your investment daily, right? Passive income. A project we decided will be a great way to reward early adopters. So if you're watching this video, you're possibly an early adopter, giving them a way to stack up DEG, which will be of central utility in the upcoming features. All right, tokenomics. DEG allocation and distribution. DeFi Empire Gold DEG allocation is predetermined according to the following table: reward pool, presale, liquidity locked, team development, partners marketing, so on. DEG allocation is all right there, right? Make sure you read through the whole white paper. Now let's look at the first game, Jace the Aspiring Adventurer. Jace decides to fund adventurers, expeditions, so that they bring him a share of their loot, making him a fair amount of daily income, thus giving him the free time he needs to train and sharpen his skills in order to become an adventurer himself and explore the mysterious world beyond the empire. Jace wants to hire as many adventurers as he can to collect as much DeFi Empire gold as possible, a currency he will be needing for future adventures, right? How to play. This is key. Once you hire an adventurer, he starts bringing you daily income immediately. I don't know about you, but I like daily income immediately. The yield can be reinvested to hire more adventurers and compound your earnings or sell your profits, okay? To start playing, you need to, one, specify how many DEG you want to spend on hiring adventurers, then click hire. Two, once the first step is completed, your adventurers will start exploring and earning DEG for you right away. Three, you can sell your DEG or use it to hire more adventurers, making your daily income larger. You can sell the loot the adventurers bring you, but you can't sell the adventurers themselves. You only hire them. They are there to bring you loot indefinitely. So, to simplify, you have an investment, you buy adventurers. You cannot get that investment back. Those adventurers go out and get loot, right? They go out and make you money. They bring you DEG tokens. Then the DEG tokens that your adventurers earn you, you can claim and take profit, or you can reinvest in more adventurers, depending on your strategy, right? Sustainability, which is a big factor. Here are the key points that make this project sustainable in the long term, almost impossible to drain out the reward pool, especially in the first 5 to 6 months. This is very important. The Adventurer Jace contract is open source and can be viewed on BSC scan. Rug-free and immutable, there are no functions that the devs can use to drain the reward pool or change the contract operations. Okay, they cannot drain the reward pool or change the contract operations, which is huge. The Adventurer Jace contract is sustainable due to our 3% maximum daily return, and considering that many users will be regularly compounding their daily returns for larger future profits. Even in worst cases, where people only withdraw and stop reinvesting, the contract will protect itself, reducing the price of adventurers faster, which will result in the decrease of the daily earnings to make it sustainable over time. The contract will then start a new cycle with cheaper adventurers, making it extremely more profitable to reinvest rather than withdraw, which will make the value of adventurers rise again, and with it, the daily profits. So this is huge. The DeFi Empire ecosystem will gradually grow, and with it, the utility for DEG, which will create a high demand for the token. At least one new future project per 2 months. At least one new feature per 2 months. The contract uses a perfect mathematical algorithm that will be sustainable over time, despite yielding an incredible 3% daily profits. So the key takeaway you need to understand is 3% daily profits, right? Another key takeaway you need to understand is you're watching this video, hopefully before the launch, even before the presale, right? So you have an opportunity, if you look at this and decide this is something that you think has potential, right, to get in early, right, and hire these adventurers. These adventurers will make you 3% a day as the token price of DEG increases, okay? Referral system. This feature will include a referral system that allows you to invite new members so that the contract sends a value equal to 10% of every investment they make to your collected gold, which you can choose to use to hire even more adventurers or just sell. Leaderboard. So it's not out yet, but when it comes out, I'll get my referral link. And if you're seeing this video, I would highly appreciate it if you use my referral link. It's a way to show love and support back to me for creating all this content. Leaderboard. The leaderboard will contain the players with the highest amount of hired adventurers. There will be a special reward only for those in the leaderboard. This will bring competitiveness to the game, which will make it even more interesting and profitable for everyone. One reason I think this project is going to perform very well is because there was another project that recently performed very well. And this is modeled in a sense after that. But I think there have been some upgrades and some improvements with this one, right? Roadmap. Here's the roadmap. You can just go ahead and look at it. So social media, website, white paper, DEG presale, public sale. So that's what I'm talking about now, right? Jace the Aspiring Adventurer, NFT Mint, Guards and Thieves, Liquidity Farm, Jace's first quest, more details on upcoming features. Liquidity Farm. This feature will be a gamified way to gain rewards for providing liquidity to our ecosystem. Farm reward. By stacking LP tokens, you get those by providing liquidity. So you pair DEG with BNB and you'll make a yield on that. Guards and Thieves, a game where you can stake your NFTs and win variant rewards depending on your NFT and other aspects that will be revealed soon. More details coming. JC's first quest. This is the first step toward exploring the pixel art RPG fantasy themed world where JC ventures. Okay, pretty cool, right? So there's game theory to it. Let's look at the site now. Pretty neat. JC the Aspiring Adventurer, hire adventurers and get daily passive income in return. Read the white paper, right? That's the first one that's going to be launched in a couple of days. Then later on, released in March and April, will be the Liquidity Farm, right? And then after that will be the first quest, right? So they have a roadmap where they're thinking ahead. They're building an ecosystem. They're not just releasing a token. The token has utility. The token is likely to increase in value. The token can be invested to buy these adventurers, which is going to yield a 3% daily return on investment, which if you do the math, I mean, 3% daily, if the token price were to stay the same, you'll almost break even in 30 days, right? But the token price is likely to increase, being that it is a launch, that it is a new project, and that when people are earning 3% a day consistently and it's sustainable, word is going to get around and it's likely that a lot of capital is going to come into the project, thus boosting the price of the token, thus boosting the whole system, the rewards and all of that, right? So there's the website. Let's see what we have here. This was the presale, like I said. So this right here says, right here it was starts at the 20th. So today's the 19th. That is tomorrow. Okay. That is tomorrow. So if I will show you in the Discord, actually, or the Telegram, that's what I was looking for. Open Telegram. Let's look in the Telegram. After holding a community vote, we have decided on the following: locking the presale tokens from being claimed until the 23rd at 4 p.m. That's good news, right? So the presale for whitelisted people is tomorrow, okay? They're going to lock those tokens until the 23rd. The aspiring adventurer will be released on the 23rd at 8 p.m., 4 hours later. Okay, so I want you to understand why they're doing this. The listing on PancakeSwap will be on the 22nd, okay? So whitelist presale tomorrow, open public presale, but there's a limited amount of tokens the next day, and then they're launching on PancakeSwap. But understand, the presalers cannot sell their tokens. They cannot claim their tokens until the day after it is listed on PancakeSwap. So that is good news for you. Even if you're not on the presale, right, you can still get in the 22nd. You're still early, right, on launch day, right? So try to get in on the public presale if you can. If you're not able for some reason, or they sell out super fast, which honestly, it's highly likely they're going to sell out super fast. There's a lot of eyes on this project, and in my opinion, there's some potential here. So either way, when it is listed on PancakeSwap, you can get the tokens right here, right? And then understand that the presalers and all that won't get their tokens till the 23rd, a day later, okay? But also, when they make it claimable for presalers, the game starts 4 hours later, okay? So any presalers that sell all their tokens or sell some of their tokens are not going to be able to invest those tokens into the game where they're going to be making 3% a day. So it's not really a wise decision, in my opinion, for them to sell their tokens if they believe in the project and the ecosystem and where it's going. A wise investor is likely going to hold on to that asset because they know that it's going to appreciate and they understand what that can do for them in the short, mid to long term. So there's that. Let's also look at the Discord briefly. All the links will be in the description, everything that you need, okay? So here we are. After holding a community vote, we have decided on the following: locking the presale tokens. We just discussed that, right? So that's in the Discord. And they actually had the community vote on that, which is super cool. So they're engaged with the community. They're asking the community, hey, should we do this? Should we do that? The community is responding, and they're actually working with the community. So that's pretty awesome. So guys, I will include the links to this, right? DefiEmpireGames.com, in my opinion, has potential. A protocol that was just like this recently came out and performed extremely well, okay? Extremely well. This project, in my opinion, has the same but actually bigger potential. That's speculative, but I see what they're doing. I understand the direction they're going. I see their site. I see their ecosystem. I do think it has potential. However, you have to research for yourself. I cannot nor will I tell you to invest in anything because I am not your financial advisor, okay? I can tell you that I will be investing in this, but that's all I can say. So anyways, if you get value out of this video, like this video, comment on this video, and if you're not subscribed to the channel, what are you doing? Subscribe to the channel, click the bell for notifications because you're going to receive time-sensitive videos just like this, all right? Anyways, guys, the links will be in the description. When they do release and launch, I will put my referral link in the description. I would highly appreciate it if you would go through my link. It would just show me appreciation back for taking the time and the energy to make these videos. Until the next video, guys, be blessed.